Hello students, welcome to Shorab Sir's classes. So in today's video, we'll be talking about a question. So in this question, we'll be talking about effects of a export subsidy. So in this video, we'll be talking about the effects of an import, the effects of an export subsidy. So the effects of an export subsidy. So this will explain. So we know that countries use trade policy to boost export. So country usually use trade policies to do what? To boost export. So country usually use trade policies to boost export. Now we know export subsidies are government assistance to domestic firms in competing with foreign firms. So export subsidies are government assistance to domestic firms. Export subsidies are what? Export subsidies are government assistance Export subsidies are government's assistance to domestic firms in competing with foreign firms. To domestic firms in competing with foreign firms. Competing with foreign firms. Now we know this can vary from outright subsidy to cheap credit or exemption from certain domestic taxes. So this can vary from outright subsidy to cheap credit to exemption from certain domestic taxes. For example, in figure 1 that we are going to draw now. So in this figure, say on the vertical axis we measure domestic price and on the horizontal axis we measure quantity. On the horizontal axis we measure quantity. This is the demand and supply curve. So in this figure, we know that economics effects of an export subsidy on a good such as computer. Suppose the world price of a good is 5,000. Suppose the world price of the good is 5,000. Suppose the world price is given as, how much it is given as? 5,000. Now, under free trade, domestic consumer buy a quantity QD at point G on their demand curve. So domestic customer buys a quantity, how much? It is equals to QD. So they consume a commodity QD at point G. Now we know on the demand curve, a producer make a quantity QC at point E on their supply curve. The quantity GE is exported. So the consumer consume how much? Producer consume at point E. This is good. So this amount is what has been exported. This amount has to be exported because there is excess supply. So this excess supply part will be exported. Now we know to help domestic producers, if government offers a 20% export subsidy on the good. So now to help domestic producer, now all of a sudden government decides to help domestic producers. Help domestic producers. If government decides for 20% of subsidy, if government decides for 20% of subsidy, so for this reason we know now if government imposes 20% of subsidy, then what happens is that now domestic producer now earn up to 600,000 at this level. So now they earn at 6,000. So according to it, you exchange the supply curve. Now as you can see, the quantity demanded has fallen, the quantity supplied has increased. So now the export has increased from this brown line to this green line. So this amount export has increased. So now there are two points A and B we have found. So now what happens is that now the export are A, B. So the subsidy increases export but entails a social cost. Now this, due to this subsidy, export subsidy, the export increases but it comes with a cost. It comes with a cost. So what is that cost? So the cost is basically triangle H is the social cost of reducing domestic consumption for QD to QD dash. So this is the what, this portion is the cost, social cost. So this portion is the social cost. And another social cost that is happening here is that this triangle, this triangle is another social cost which is happening because we have increased the outputs, and this social cost due to lack of consumption, and this social cost due to increase in output. So here what happens, marginal domestic cost exceeds the world price of import. Just as with a tariff, the export subsidy is usually a second based policy. So it is usually a second based policy. So we would consider what, export subsidy a second based policy. Export subsidy is the second best policy. Even if a country wants to raise its output of computers, it is cheaper to use a production subsidy incurring cost of triangle K, production subsidy incurring this triangle, but avoiding the cost of triangle H, but avoiding the cost of triangle this triangle. So it happens that just as with tariff and export subsidy is the second best policy, even in the country wants to raise its output of computers, it is cheaper to use a production subsidy. So it is easier, cheaper to use a production subsidy It is cheaper to use a production subsidy incurring the cost of triangle K but avoiding the cost of triangle H, but avoiding the cost of triangle, so this triangle, so we can easily avoid this triangle. So this is the effect of export subsidy on trade. So I hope you guys liked it. If you still have any query or doubts regarding this question, you can simply WhatsApp me on this number which is 9836793076, or you can also go to our website, which is www.showroofsersclasses.com. There you will find a lot of other videos like this, and you will also get to see a lot of other materials which are needed for different entrance exams. So thank you for watching this video and have a nice day ahead.